COVID-19 and communities of color, and I will focus on understanding social inequities as well as the opportunities for building community immunity for future pandemics. So we've gotten a big sense of some of the challenges producing these inequities. I want to shift to talk about what can we do about it. How do we build community immunity? We need to think of how we can create communities of opportunity that will minimize, neutralize, and dismantle the systems of racism that create inequities in health. We need to build trust to improve patient-provider relationships and the quality of medical care. Medical mistrust is a problem. It's driven for many by misinformation. It's driven for others by historical or ongoing injustice. Mistrust is typically viewed as a characteristic of an individual or community. I am strongly suggesting that we rethink about mistrust as a phenomenon created, sustained, reinforced by a system that is generating social inequality. Medical mistrust matters profoundly. It leads to lower utilization of care, lower adherence to medical advice, poorer management of health conditions, lower likelihood of good long-term relationships with health providers. It, in fact, contributes to racial disparities in care. Medical mistrust is not merely the opposite of trust or the absence of trust. It is not just about interpersonal trust, but also about trust in institutions and systems. And medical mistrust is a protective response on the part of disadvantaged communities against interlocking systemic inequities in education, in jobs, in housing, in healthcare, dealing with daily discrimination, stigma, and so on. So let me conclude by talking about what is holding us back. And I would argue there are three communication challenges. Most Americans are unaware that racial inequities in health exist. Maybe in the post-COVID-19, there's greater awareness. But we also need to build a science base to develop the political will, and we need to build empathy. W.E.B. Du Bois, a giant intellectual, African-American intellectual of the late 19th, early 20th century, wrote a book in 1899 about the Philadelphia Negro, has a chapter on Negro health, and he laid out the disparities in health that existed in 1899 in Philadelphia. And he came to the end of the chapter. He said, the most difficult problem with racial disparities in health is the peculiar attitude of the nation. He continued, there have been few other cases in the history of civilized people where human suffering has been viewed with such peculiar indifference. In fact, as this recent review shows, there's a racial in-group bias found across the world. These are studies of brain imagery, seeing persons of your own race or of a different race suffer. Do you empathize with them? And if they are of a different race, you're less likely to. What's the policy implications of this racial bias, this empathy, lack of empathy? When we lack empathy for a group, we do not support policies to address the needs of that group. So we need to find ways to build empathy, but we also need a commitment to equity. Equality gives everyone the same thing. Equity provides what everyone needs in order that they can thrive. Equality is a good idea if we all start at the same place, but when we are unequal, then equality is not the optimal idea. There are many edifices that have produced the racial disparities in health that we deal with, we have dealt with for hundreds of years, and we still deal with today. We need to make a new commitment to restructure those edifices.